Hi, thank you for joining us. I'm Tiffani Kavalec, the Chief of the Division of Surface Water at Ohio EPA. Harmful algal blooms impact Western Lake Erie. The state of Ohio has declared Western Lake Erie as impaired for recreation and drinking water uses. Ohio is now developing the Maumee Watershed Nutrient TMDL to address these impairments. We have prepared three presentations to explain what this process is and what is being done to address this impairment. In this first module, we will outline Ohio's total maximum daily load development process. We will also explain how this project is our first TMDL that addresses what we call Farfield impairments. In the second module, we will provide an overview of the Maumee Watershed Nutrient TMDL project itself. A third presentation module will explain the ongoing nutrient reduction efforts that are occurring across the Maumee Watershed. Ohio EPA develops TMDLs, or total maximum daily loads, for surface waters that are not meeting water quality goals. We call these waters impaired. A TMDL determines the maximum amount of a given pollutant that can be discharged into the water body and still allow that water body to meet its goals. Maximum amounts of the pollutant are allocated or assigned to all the sources, example, point sources, non-point sources, and then the plan recommends implementation actions to meet reduction goals. As shown in this graphic, TMDLs are a continual process built upon watershed surveys and adaptive or flexible management. We start with assessing the situation, then develop a strategy, implement that strategy, but continue to evaluate and adapt the strategy as necessary. TMDLs establish the target for restoration of water bodies that are out of balance. They are planning tools that contain no regulatory requirements in and of themselves. TMDLs are implemented through permitting programs for point sources and incentive programs for non-point sources. TMDLs are not rules and do not establish new regulations or regulatory power. Revisions to state law in 2017 created a new stakeholder involvement process for Ohio's TMDL projects. We now have five steps in which interested parties can review and comment on documents prepared for various stages in the TMDL development process. The dot graphic illustrates the five steps. Most watershed projects start with a study plan, which is also called a Quality Assurance Project Plan, or QAP. For near-field projects, the study plan announces the project and details where the agency will be sampling and what parameters we will be sampling for. The results of the sampling are typically compiled into the Biological and Water Quality Report, often the second step in the process. This report details attainment status of sampling locations and, if a location is impaired, lists the causes and sources of impairment. Sometimes you will also hear the agency call this document a TSD, or Technical Support Document. The third step, the Loading Analysis Plan, outlines the agency's plan for a TMDL. This plan is used to set pollutant targets to address impairments within the defined area. The fourth step, preliminary modeling results, contains the results of the pollutant load distribution or allocation from all sources along with draft implementation recommendations. The fifth step is the official draft TMDL report, which pulls together results of all the previous steps. This document has a 60-day public comment period, while the other four steps have a 30-day comment period. As mentioned before, this is the typical process for a watershed-based TMDL like the agency has prepared in the past. All previous TMDLs that Ohio EPA has developed addressed local impacts. Local impacts include things like the biology of a particular stream when it doesn't meet expectations, or a community's drinking water source has too much of a pollutant, or a stream or beach has too much bacteria, indicating swimming is not safe. The pollutants causing these impacts are from local sources. By that I mean nearby sources of pollutants are causing nearby local impacts. We call these projects Nearfield TMDLs. The Maumee Watershed Nutrient TMDL is a Farfield TMDL. I'll explain what that means in a minute, but first, we are going to take a moment to go over existing Nearfield TMDL projects in the Maumee Watershed. This map depicts the status of Nearfield TMDL projects for watersheds within the Maumee Watershed. Watersheds in green are in the loading analysis plan step three of our process. These include the watersheds of the Tiffani, Lower Auglaize, St. Mary's Rivers, the upper and middle Maumee River tributaries, along with the Maumee River main stem. As depicted in orange, the St. Joseph River draft TMDL report will likely be ready for stakeholder input this year. Watersheds in blue have approved TMDL reports already. Those include the Upper Auglaize, Ottawa and Blanchard Rivers, the Swan and Powell Creeks, and the Lower Maumee and Lake Erie tributaries. We are starting the second round of the TMDL process for the blue hatched watersheds, meaning we have completed a watershed survey and finalized a TMDL to address impairments that were found. And now, we have resurveyed the watershed to follow up on the TMDL implementation. These projects are in round two of the continuous process. These include the Upper Auglaize River and the Lower Maumee and Lake Erie tributaries. The map on the previous slide shows that about half of the Maumee watershed is covered with TMDLs, and TMDLs are in development for the rest. This may seem like a large amount. However, through a project called Connecting Annex 4 to TMDL Targets, it was realized that the Maumee River watershed has too few near-field nutrient TMDLs within each of those projects to meet the nutrient reduction targets that have been set by Annex 4. Annex 4 is part of the Great Lakes Water Quality Agreement, a binational effort between the U.S. and Canada to coordinate actions to manage nutrients, including nutrient loading in the Great Lakes. These next few slides go about explaining what makes the Maumee Watershed Nutrient TMDL a Farfield TMDL. The blue areas of this map show Michigan and Canada's portion of Lake Erie. Ohio's portion of Lake Erie is broken up into seven assessment units. The western basin of Lake Erie is made up of three of the seven assessment units. The three areas in the blue circle are the mainland western basin shoreline, the western basin open water, and the Ohio Lake Erie Islands shoreline. We evaluate the status of water quality in assessment units and report out on them every 2 years in the Ohio Integrated Water Quality Monitoring and Assessment Report. In the 2020 Integrated Water Quality Monitoring and Assessment Report, all three Western Basin assessment units were listed as impaired or not meeting water quality goals for recreation and public drinking water due to the presence of harmful algal blooms and the toxins they can produce. The 2020 Integrated Report also declared Ohio's commitment to developing a TMDL report to address these impairments within the next 2 to 3 years. In order to do that, we must address the nutrients most responsible for Western Lake Erie harmful algal blooms. We know from water quality monitoring work of the Annex 4 Subcommittee and Ohio's Nutrient Mass Balance Report that excessive nutrients entering the western basin of Lake Erie are coming from the Maumee River and the network of rivers that feed into it. We know from the Connecting Annex 4 to TMDL Targets project, explained a few slides ago, that addressing nutrient issues with near-field TMDL projects is not going to get Ohio to the needed reduction targets. The Maumee River acts as a very efficient conduit at transporting sediment and nutrients into the western basin. A Farfield vision for this project is necessary. Reductions of nutrients from the entire watershed are needed to address the downstream impairment in the lake. Therefore, we are calling this project a Farfield TMDL to distinguish it from our typical Nearfield TMDL projects. As you see from this graphic, the Maumee River watershed extends into Michigan and Indiana. This Farfield TMDL will focus on Ohio-specific reduction goals, but coordination with these states will continue, and their own efforts will be described further in Modules 2 and 3. Ohio EPA has created a webpage where all the information regarding this project is being posted. Here is a snapshot of the page and the web address. In Module 2, we will go through all of the information compiled so far for this project. Stakeholder involvement is key to the TMDL process. The best way to ensure you receive information from Ohio EPA is to create an account and sign up for the TMDL listserv at the web address on this slide. We currently have three options: statewide TMDLs, Ohio River Basin TMDLs, and Lake Erie Basin TMDLs. Any updates regarding the Maumee Watershed Nutrient TMDL project will be sent to the statewide and Lake Erie Basin lists. So we encourage everyone who wants to stay engaged, please register for one or more of these. To summarize the key points of this module, TMDLs outline the maximum amount of pollutants that can be delivered to an impaired water body in order to address the impairment. These are planning tools and do not have any regulatory powers in their own right. Ohio has an official TMDL process. Each project has 5 steps that allow stakeholders and the public to provide input. The third step, the development of the loading analysis plan, is where the decision to move forward with a full TMDL is described. While the Maumee Watershed has many local TMDL projects, existing or in development, these near-field TMDLs have too few local areas impacted by nutrients to expect enough nutrient reduction to address Lake Erie harmful algal bloom impacts. Therefore, we are now developing a Farfield TMDL that will address nutrient reductions for all of Ohio's portion of the Maumee River watershed. We encourage you to view the second and third modules of this series when they become available. The second module will explain the material being used to fulfill the first 2 steps of this TMDL project and explain the now in development loading analysis plan. The third module will outline the extensive efforts already underway to address nutrient reductions to Lake Erie and provide some insight on new actions that this TMDL may help drive. Thank you for your time and interest in this project.